My name is Dr. Laura Ashbran. I am an associate veterinarian at Alicia Pet Care Center. I'd say I've done hundreds of lap spays. I've been doing it for about 9 to 10 years. I love lap spays because I'm also very fast at them now. So it probably takes me about 10 to 15 minutes to do a laparoscopic spay. And today I performed a laparoscopic spay on Capri. The reason why we perform and offer laparoscopic spays, just as in people, it is less invasive and also tends to be less painful. And the studies have shown that laparoscopic spays are considerably less painful than a traditional spay. And so the difference is we're gonna be making a much smaller incision with a laparoscopic spay. We only need a centimeter. Just because we're cutting through less tissue, that is another reason why it's less painful with a laparoscope. In our laparoscopic spays, we're only removing the ovaries, and by doing so, it is also less traumatic, where with a traditional spay in the United States, we've always been taught how to remove the ovary and the uterus. Both ways are completely acceptable and healthy for the pet. But one of the biggest aspects that causes pain with a traditional spay is we actually have to manually break down a ligament called the suspensory ligament. And that's what attaches the ovary to the inside of the body wall. Where with a laparoscopic spay, we just use cautery and it's much less painful and traumatic. And also we just have very good visualization, which is one of my favorite things about doing laparoscopic spays, is how well you're able to see everything that you're doing and visualize all the organs very clearly when you're doing a laparoscopic spay compared to a traditional spay. In a laparoscopic spay, it is a sterile procedure, so the patient is fully anesthetized, sterilely prepped for surgery. We completely gown and glove and scrub for surgery, and then we come into one of our OR rooms. First, the pet, actually interesting, is put into one of these tables called a tippy table and secured. Then for the procedure, we actually make a centimeter incision just caudal to their umbilicus, so on their ventral abdomen. And all we need is a centimeter because that's how big the scope is that's going to go in. Once we get all the way through, we are able to insert the laparoscope and we inflate the abdomen using CO2. And with it inflated and with the scope, we're able to see everything through the camera on our screens to see everything inside the abdomen. Because there's lots of organs in the abdomen, we actually use this table to gently tip them to the side, and this will help make sure all the intestines and everything move out of the way and we're able to easily identify the ovary and the uterus. And then with that, we isolate the ovary and we can see everything visually with our camera. And then we insert a tool called a force triad, which is an electrocautery and cutting instrument. And with this, we're able to just visually just remove just the ovary is what we do. And the electrocautery helps make sure that there is no bleeding from any of the blood vessels. And then we repeat the same procedure on the other side and we just remove the ovaries from the abdomen. So no matter what, if there has been an incision, it's still gonna take the body about 10 to 14 days to heal an incision. But because we're less traumatic and less painful with a laparoscopic spay, they're gonna feel better faster. Also, you're gonna have much less complication potential. We have quite a lot of young, very hyper and energetic dogs that really don't wanna be quiet for 2 weeks after a surgery. And it can be kind of difficult to keep them calm, and that can cause complications with a surgery. Now, if we only have a centimeter incision, less likely to have any complications compared to when you have to make a larger abdominal incision.